Howdy lads and ladies, and as promised, I'm going to smoke my new James Upshall pipe for the first time. I didn't mention my other video, this is a new pipe. Maybe I'll annotate that. It's never been smoked before, and when I ordered it, I really had some qualms about ever doing that. Maddie assured me, though, that the pipe should be smoked. I put a video on about that very problem I was having, but you know, I waited for it so long and dreamed about smoking this pipe. I'm going to smoke it, and I'm going to smoke it on camera for the first time, so that should be interesting. Here we go. As Rudyard Kipling said in The Man Would Be King, you shall watch me light up. Well, I was hoping to get a light off my old match, but I guess we'll just have to strike instead. Time for a little tamp, I think. You know, it just occurred to me a funny kind of a thing. Whenever I make these videos, I have this feeling, this kind of a feeling or belief that the videos are going out live, and that if I do something really stupid, that you're going to see it. And then it always occurs to me a minute or so, you know, a few seconds later, well, no, it's not live, it's on tape, and I can always erase it. Though if I did something really stupid, you'd be sure to see it, because it'd probably break you up, but I'd find it funny too. I'm smoking English in here, by the way, Northwoods. My favorite English, probably my favorite tobacco, so. Tamp it again. It's really chunky stuff, so. Maybe that got that time, we'll see. Very interesting. You know, I've done a lot of reading online about pipes and pipe smoking, and some of the masters of pipe smoking, you know, and people who know about it, you know, talk about how different pipes taste. I have noticed that Costello pipes have a very distinct taste to them, a very nice taste. In my opinion, sweet, nutty, I'm quite fond of it, especially my little bit bulldogs like that, and my other ones that way too, in a different kind of a way. And I wasn't sure how a James Upshall was going to smoke. I've read things online about them where people said that they take a while to break in, or you know, one thing I read was the guy said it does take a while to break it in the way he likes it, but they smoke real good initially anyway, and then they become some of the best smokers he's had. GLP said that. What I'm sensing here is that I'm tasting kind of a musky of a dark taste, a little bit, just a very light, but a kind of a musky, I won't say woody. But definitely a dark, kind of a musky, different kind of a taste with this pipe and this tobacco. And to my surprise, that taste perfectly complements this English tobacco. It's actually enhancing it. It's actually enhancing it, like almost like it was made to be together now. Maybe just my imagination, because I've longed to smoke an English tobacco in an actual English pipe, because all my other pipes are actually Italian, except for my other James Upshall, which I haven't smoked yet. They're all pretty much Italian. Do I have any pipes that aren't Italian? I have one Danish pipe and another English pipe that I've never smoked, so. So anyway, that's interesting. That is a pleasant surprise to have that nice flavor in there that enhances the tobacco the way it does. I find that Northwoods, my Northwoods came fairly moist. And no matter how I pack it, and I pack it well, I pack it the way it needs to be packed, but it tends to need often relights, which I don't mind. Like, I kind of like that, because then I get a nice relight and I get a lot more smoke out of it, and very nice, like just now. These pipes are made with Grecian plateau briar from Greece. Which I guess is a really good briar. I'm not sure. I know nothing about pipe making, so I don't know what that means, but I know this has got a real nice taste to it. It's got a very nice flavor to it, especially for the English tobacco. And I don't know if that's intentional, if something they do or did, or again, Barry, who makes these pipes, Barry Jones, is a kind of a pipe wizard, in my opinion, when I read about him. And no offense, Barry, but Barry looks a bit like a hobbit to me. But so does Azrati. Monty Azrati looks a bit like a hobbit. Big giant hobbit to me, which is a great compliment coming from me, by the way. And he must have some innate, you know, Barry must have some innate elfin-like wizardry with pipes, because this is the perfect pipe for an English tobacco. Well, there you go, smoking the James Upshall apple for the first time. Quite nice, quite wonderful. I'm very happy with it. Alrighty, friends, I'll see you later.